Sir, I'm calling because of some statements you've been making this past week about,
yeah.
About the religion of Islam. And, you know, I...
It's a cult. It's not even a religion.
You know, sir, I have to say, I don't even know why you're making such statements. The thing is...
Hey, Will, get real. You know damned well why I'm making such statements. Watch the news, Will. Read newspapers, Will. Look at what Muslims are doing around the world, Will. Look at school children shot in the back, Will. Bombs thrown in the nurseries in Israel, Will. And then don't get on the air and tell me, I don't even know why you're making these statements about Islam.
All right, well, the thing is, I don't know, maybe you don't have a lot of Muslims calling to your show to give their point
of view. Are you a Muslim?
Yes, sir. Yes,
converted?
Sir. Excuse me?
Converted?
No, sir. No.
Oh, you were born a Muslim?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So the thing is, maybe you don't have a lot of Muslims tell you their
I got one right now. Tell me what's going on.
Okay, so I can tell you that Islam certainly does not condone any of the crimes
Horse
that have been
crap.
Portrayed.
Horse crap.
Hold on, Mr. Boyce.
Don't tell me to hold on, and don't give me this Islam doesn't condone. We've got outrage right now. You're on hold. I'll make the statement, and then you come back and tell me where I'm wrong. We've got Muslims right now that are outraged over cartoons, okay? Over cartoons. Muslims fly commercial airliners into buildings in New York City. No Muslim outrage. Muslim officials block the exit where schoolgirls are trying to escape a burning building because their faces are exposed. No Muslim outrage. Muslims cut off the heads of three teenage girls on their way to school. No Muslim outrage. Muslims murder teachers trying to teach Muslim children in Iraq. No Muslim outrage. Muslims murder 80 tourists with car bombs outside cafes and hotels in Egypt. No Muslim outrage. They attack a missionary children's school in India, kill six of them. No Muslim outrage. Muslims fire rocket-propelled grenades into schools full of children in Israel. No Muslim outrage. Okay? On and on. We go to Bali, wherever. Look around. And then Muslim newspapers publish anti-Semitic cartoons. No Muslim outrage. Muslims beat the charred bodies of Western civilians with their shoes, hang them from a bridge. No Muslim outrage. And then newspapers in Denmark and Norway print cartoons of Muhammad, and all of a sudden, Muslims are outraged. And Will, you know what? You need to own up to it. You need to own up to the problem is not talk show hosts. The problem is not newspapers in Denmark and Norway. The problem is that Muslims like you get ticked off when somebody calls the Muslim world to account, but you don't get ticked off at what Muslims are doing around the world.
Well, sir, the only thing I can say is that for the long list of crimes that you just cited, as a Muslim, I am most definitely outraged.
You have never, ever called this show to express outrage over any of them.
Mr. Boris, I've tried to call your show on several occasions. Just today I realized I can call about an hour early and get in.
You weren't on an hour early.
Oh, well, in my location, it seems
yeah.
to be. But I've tried to call in on multiple occasions. Just today I was able to get in, and I can tell you on the air, as a Muslim, I am very outraged, I am very disgusted about the long list of crimes that you just cited.
You got on the air today, and instead of expressing outrage over the long list of crimes committed in the name of your religion, you launched right into an attack on me for what I've said about Islam. So your words ring absolutely hollow. You got on the air, and you had nothing to say about the list of atrocities committed by the wonderful, peaceful religion of Islam. You had nothing to say about it until I brought them up. So don't give me this nonsense about how you would have loved to have called to condemn all those things. You don't have a word of condemnation in you until the non-Islamic world rises up and starts to make it clear that we are fed up with your damned religion. We've had it up to here. And somebody, like I said yesterday, somebody needs to grab the Muslim world by the shirt collar, backhand it a good one, knock it into the damn corner, and say, straighten up or we're going to eradicate you beetles from the face of the earth.
As far as the crimes that you just mentioned, definitely Islam does not condone or support it. It deplores it, and anyone
you
who
do
thinks,
not speak
and anyone,
for Islam.
Anyone,
I'm through with you. You do not speak for Islam. You can't call up here and say definitely Islam does not support it. Islam is involved in it around the world, And the Muslim street doesn't get outraged until somebody prints a cartoon of Mohammed. Then they get outraged. And you call it, well, the Muslims, we condemn all these things. Where were you when they happened? And don't give me this nonsense that magically you only managed to get through to this radio program today. When I, after my statements about this outrage over these cartoons of Mohammed. You know, I understand. I understand that these bloodthirsty Islamic murderers do not represent the majority of the world's Muslims. When, though, do the rest of you become outraged? When do you take to the streets to express your outrage at the radicals that are making your religion the worldwide object of hatred and ridicule? I mean, Salman Rushdie one time, he wrote 3 years ago in the New York Times, he said, as their ancient, deeply civilized culture of love, art, and philosophical reflection is hijacked by paranoiacs, racists, liars, male supremacists, tyrants, fanatics, and violence junkies, why are they not screaming? And that's the question for you, Will. As your religion, if you want to phrase it this way, as your religion is hijacked by paranoiacs, racists, liars, male supremacists, tyrants, fanatics, and violence junkies, why aren't you screaming? But when you get on this radio program, all you have is to criticize me for what I've said about Islam. You did not try to call when they murdered hundreds of school children in Basra, shooting them in the back. You didn't call. You didn't call to express as a Muslim your outrage that what had happened over there. Bally anywhere. You wait for somebody to criticize your religion, some infidel, some non-believer like me, some Christian, some Jew. When they criticize your religion, all of a sudden it's outrage time. But not until then. You just sit back and accept it while your religion goes on a bloody, violent, worldwide rampage. And the rest of the world better wake up to what's going on here. If you want a peaceful religion of love and reflection and philosophy, do it. If you want a violent religion, we're more than ready to stand up to you and trade blows.